Demonstrating now replica plate technique. So here we have a master plate which has isolated colonies onto it. We're going to do the replica of this onto your replica plate, which is your erythritol plate, because we're looking out for vitamin B12 auxotrophs, and we have an efficiency plate which is a complete medium. So to begin with, we are going to take the replica block, sterile replica block. Okay, and we're going to open it in between the burners and keep it upright like this, or supporting onto a tripod strand. Next, so okay, before we proceed, you're going to pull out the cloth down tightly. After which we're going to take a scalpel, flame sterilize it, and make the fibers of the velvet straight and erect so that they can act as inoculating needles. After this, we are going to put the master plate, as we call it, from which we are going to now inoculate the needles of the velveteen cloth. So we're going to gently tap it. A very important thing is to do the marking. So we're going to mark our master plate along with the marking on the block. This will enable you to match the colonies on the replica and efficiency plate after the incubation is over. That is your day 2 incubation. So first we will take our replica plate. Now that our block is inoculated, we're going to place it here. We're going to tap it with a marker so that gently, two markings over here. First is this marking which we had made onto the block. Coinciding with that, we're going to make it on the replica plate. And along with that, we're going to mark the area, because if you see, the block is not covering the entire plate. So we're going to mark out where we have inoculated. So our replica plate is being inoculated. Next, we take the efficiency plate, do the same as we did for the replica plate.